Okay, today we need
This
to.
call is now being recorded.
Okay, good morning once again, children. Good morning.
Good morning.
Good morning. Good morning.
Good morning. Good morning. Good morning. Now, the other day we did this lesson. I explained a friend in need. I hope all of you have understood till where we have done. Okay, so what was the last thing that, huh? Where were we? Can anyone tell me? Is the water property? We did all that?
Ma'am, yes, ma'am, we did this.
Then they banged their fist on Rajam's door. We did this, no? Yes, we also explained about, see how
yes,
they were kneeling
this
down
book
and.
Is done.
Okay, then here. Okay,
From
this
here
we
we
did.
have to
We
start.
did.
From
Didn't,
here we have to start.
Yes. From Rajam's room, I suppose, no? Yes. Anyway, we'll start from here. The other day we read. So the three friends were Rajam, Mani, and Swaminathan. And Mani's enemies were Somu, Shankar, and P. Isn't it? So once Rajam calls Mani and Swaminathan to his house, and on the way they are actually talking to each other, discussing that what is Rajam going to surprise us with. Me, like, they were all thinking of different things, you know, that maybe he wants to show us some monkey, or he wants to show us something or do something, but he's not told us like what he's going to show us. And so what happens when somebody doesn't show you and he just tells you, I want to show you something, you know, you get a curiosity, you want to know now that what is there, isn't it? Sometimes your friend tells me that I will tell you afterwards something, so till she tells you, you are not, you know, content, you want to listen to it. So that curiosity is there to know or to learn something. Or if somebody tells you, I've brought a gift for you, but you have to open it only when you go home. So what happens? The whole day you're thinking of opening a gift, isn't it? Because you're curious to know what is inside. In the same way, Mani and Swaminathan were curious to know why was Rajam calling them home. And they were thinking of different things. And then on the way, they are talking to each other. And suddenly the talk diverts to their enemies. So Mani says that if I meet Somu somewhere on the Kabir street, I will break the lamp of the street and I will hit him with a club. Club is a thick stick. And I'll hit him on the head and he will lie on the floor. And so they're talking about all this about enemies. That so much of enemy and hatred was there amongst them. So Rajam actually, like, and they reach the, both of them, Mani and Swaminathan, reach Rajam's house, you know that, no? And they climb the wall. So the servant, Rajam's servant, he comes running and says, why are you coming, jumping over the wall and coming? Okay, you should come by the gate. So Mani was very rude, you know, and he says, why are you bothered whether we come by the gate or by the wall, you know? And so he's saying, no, I'm only concerned because your ribs will be broken. You'll break your ribs. You'll break something. So again, he talks very rudely and says, your ribs are safe, no? Why are you bothered about our ribs, you know? And then they think that, see, we have not come to meet you. We have come to meet the police superintendent's son. They had come to meet Rajam. And then when they reach Rajam's home, they try to play some mischief. They tried to play some mischief, and what was the mischief they played on him? Can anyone tell me? What was the mischief that they did? Can anyone tell me what was the mischief? What are the pranks they were playing? Girls, listening, or you can't hear my voice? Girls? Girls? Girls, are you there?
Yes, ma'am.
Girls?
Yes, ma'am.
Oh, then why aren't you answering this? Yes, tell me. Tell me, but.
Someone. Pranking of. one's doing
try to express it clearly better. Can anybody else try? Because she cannot express herself properly. Can anybody else try better? Anyone but your name better? Alma? Okay, say Alma. Say. So what happens? What do they do? Alma, tell me first. I'm waiting for you.
What,
we have
ma'am?
To finish the lesson. I just said the mischief they played with their friend Rajam when they reached the house.
Yes.
Ma'am, can I
you
say
understood?
The money fell down on...
Not fell down. He sat in a crawling position. Yes, then? Yes, Rabia, you
Mama,
say.
Can I say, Rabia?
Yes,
Swaminathan became a blind kitten and Mani became a blind puppy. And
First time they banged the door with their fist, you know, and then they, as soon as they heard the latch open, they hid behind the pillar. And when Rajam saw that nobody was there, he opened his door, he again locked the door. Then second time, what did they do? Yes, now you can tell me that Mani and Swaminathan, they crawled down, yes? Yes, now you can tell me. Continue, Peter.
Mani and Swaminathan fell down on their knees they kept
and crawled.
Their knees and hands on the ground and they crawled. As a blind puppy and a blind kitten.
And they were making the?
And they were making the noise of kitten and puppy. And after a few seconds, Rajam was also interested in this game. So he also started playing and answering with meow and bow bow.
Yes. So, we have done this, you know, anyway. So, I just wanted a recap of this. Now, Mani remains stunned for a moment. Actually, no, from here. So, what happened? When they had closed their eyes and they were crawling in on the floor, you know, towards Rajan's room. And Rajan was also playing with them, you know, this game. And then Mani and Swaminathan, with the eyes closed, they didn't know that anybody else was there because the eyes were closed. So they thought that let us, just out of mischief, Mani thought, let me bite him, you know. And Swaminathan thought, let him scratch his leg. Let me scratch his leg. So while they were moving, one of them came near the leg and, bit the calf of the person standing there. The calf is, I told you, which part of the leg that is behind, you know, the between the knee and the ankle. After knee or ankle, se leke jo piche ka bar, the soft bar, that is called calf, okay? So, who bit the puppy? The puppy bit Rajam on his calf. And then there was some confusion, and he was surprised, you know, when he opened his eyes, he saw that it was his enemy Somu. And the blind kitten nestled, that is, comfortably came to near somebody's leg and scratched it with his paw. Scratched that person with his hand. What is the meaning of scratch? You know that when you scratch your hands or something, when you feel itchy, you scratch, isn't it? So the kitten scratched the leg that was just near, he fondled near it. And then when he opened his eyes, what did he see? Shankar. So both of them were surprised, that rather shocked. They were stunned to see their enemies there. Somu was there standing, and even Shankar was standing. And they even saw that P was sitting on a chair and was enjoying all this. Okay. Now Mani remained stunned for a moment and then scrambled to his feet. Scrambled means he was crawling, so he stood up. scrambled. He hurriedly got up. Scrambled means hurriedly got up. He looked around, face twitching with shame. You know, he was just feeling very bad, and he was ashamed of himself, but he was also angry because Rajam had invited his friends, his enemies also. So, and he saw P sitting in a corner and twinkling eyes with mischief. And P was, you know, enjoying all this, and he was, indirectly, you know, his eyes were telling that y'all wouldn't have expected us here, you know, like that type of a twinkle in his eye. Felt impelled, you know, here, and felt impelled to take him by the throat. And the boys, you know, they felt, you know, even we should catch his throat, and like he was so angry. Then, as for Swami, the best place for himself would be in the darkness. That is, when you have done something wrong, or you have done something which you are ashamed of, or something that you don't like to do in front of enemies. What do you feel, you know, if you have done something wrong and in front of enemies, you hide somewhere, isn't it? Don't you say that, it's such a time, pani mein dub jati. You know, it's a saying, you know. So, but he wanted to hide somewhere. He felt that in darkness I should go and hide, you know. So, where were he? And obscurity. So, as for Swaminathan, he felt that the best place for him would be the darkness or the obscurity under a table. Now, the meaning of obscurity is a state in which a person remains unseen or unknown. So, he thought, I hope nobody sees me. Like, I want to hide in the place somewhere where nobody sees me. So, what do you mean by this, Rajam? Mani asked, you know. So, Mani, you know, he couldn't help himself and he asked Rajam, what do you mean by this? That is, he meant to say that, what is this? Like, you called us also, you called my enemies also. So, Rajam is saying, why are you so wild? Means, why are you so angry? So, it was your fault, said Mani vehemently. That is, again, angrily, that it is your fault. I didn't know. He looked around. I didn't know, and he didn't complete the sentence, but he meant to say that I didn't know that even these people would be here. Well, well, I didn't ask you to crawl and bark, did I? So Rajam is laughing that you all made a fool of yourself, you know, by doing this. But did I ask you to crawl and bark, and did I do that? Did I ask you to do that? And Somu and company began to laugh. So, Mani's enemy, Somu and Shankar, they all laughing, the three of them. And Mani glared around. And, you know, actually, Mani felt very bad because they were laughing at him. I'm going away, Rajam. This is not the place for me. So, Mani wanted to leave the place. And he says, Rajam, I'm going away. I don't think I should be here, like, you know. So, Mani fidgeted uneasily. Now, children, when I'm explaining, if you find any difficulty, just let me know, okay? So, Mani fidgeted unrestlessly. That is, he started moving restlessly, uneasily. And Rajam took him aside and soothed him. That is, comforted him. You know, Mani was very upset and he didn't know what to do. Like, he didn't want to leave the place, nor did he want to stay in that place. He was confused. And Mani fidgeted. That is, he moved in the room restlessly here and there. And Rajam took him, pulled him aside and calmed him down, soothed him. Excuse Rajam me, then turned. Yes, beta? Yes, tell me.
Ma'am, can you please go slowly?
Oh, sorry. I'm very fast. Sorry. So again, I will just say that Mani fidgeted uneasily and Rajam took him aside. So as I told you, Mani was very restless. He was moving about in the room. And Rajam, he took him aside, told him to come in the corner somewhere and soothed him, calmed him down. That, see, you shouldn't get angry and all that. Rajam then turned to Swaminathan, who was lost in the bottomless misery. So Rajam then turned to Swaminathan. First he comforted Mani to calm down. Then he told Swaminathan, who was lost in his misery. That is, he felt very sad, you know, that this has happened, you know. So he was lost in his bottomless misery. Bottomless misery means that endless, that there was no end to his misery. He was feeling so sad. Okay. He comforted and flattered him by saying that it was best imitation of a cat and a dog. So Rajam, in fact, you know, he praised both of them. He said, he flattered means praised. And by saying that it was best imitation of a cat and a dog. So he's saying, you know, both of you are so talented. I hope I'm okay now, Rabia. I hope I'm slow now. Rabia?
Yes, ma'am.
Rabia? Now you can understand, no? I'm a bit slow now?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So, he comforted and flattered him by saying that the best imitation of a cat, your best imitation of a cat and a So he is saying that I have never seen such a natural acting, you know, and such natural the way of mewing and barking. And he said that he had ever witnessed in his life, but this is never in my witness such a natural acting, mimic, okay? He admitted that for a few minutes he was watching a real cat and a dog. So he also said, he admitted that he agreed that no, I haven't seen anybody like this. You know, he has never watched even a real cat or a dog do like y'all. You know, your acting was so real. Okay. They would get prizes if they did it in fairs. That is, if they had done it in fairs, fair, that is Mela, you know. And if you would have done there, you know, in a fair, you know, you would have got lots of prizes. So if Swaminathan and Mani would be good enough to repeat the fun, he'd be delighted. So he's saying, you know, if you, Swaminathan and Mani, he tells him, if you all do the acting again of a cat and a puppy, then, you know, I'll be delighted. I'll be very happy. And even I'll ask my father to come and watch her. Because, you know, excellently, I haven't seen anybody doing like so well like y'all. So this was soothing. So, you know, actually, Rajam praised them, flattered them. Because flattered means praise extremely. Because you over praise them, too much praise. That they are to be diverted, they will cool down, you know, because they were really angry with Rajam. But Rajam, these nice things about them, and then they were a bit happy. Okay, so this was soothing. Soothing means it was calming for them. They felt satisfied. Then Mani felt proud of themselves. You know, now they felt really proud that what we have done, you know, is praise. He's like they were praised by Rajam, their best friend. And after the round of eating that followed, they were perfectly happy. So as soon as they finished their snacks, you know, then Rajam would have offered some snacks. They all ate together and they were happy. But except when they thought of the other three in the room. So they were actually very happy that Rajam had praised them and Rajam had offered them food. But they were not happy with the thought of the other three. Who were the other three? Shankar, Shomu and P. Okay. They were in this state of mind when Raja began a lecture of friendship. So actually they were in a, you know, like in their minds, they were thinking that three of our enemies were not there. But they couldn't say. They were feeling like that. But that time, what did Rajan do? He gave a small lecture on friendship. Not small, but rather big lecture actually. Friendship. And he said, you know, that important things about friendship. So he started giving examples and saying that, see, friendship is all about being united, you know. You cannot stay united, you know, if you are not friends. So, and he started quoting from some books, some good quotations about friendship. Then the story of a dying old man and the sticks, which proved that union was a strength. So, you all know the story of the dying old man and the sticks? Do you all know the story of the old man and the sticks, children? Girls? Girls? Girls, are you listening?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am. All are sleeping, I suppose. So, the story of the old man is that he had four sons and he wanted, like, you know, to... Before he dies, he wanted to see that they are united or not. So he brings sticks. He tells one of them to bring sticks from somewhere. And then he tells each one to break one stick. So it breaks easily. But then he bundles them up and he asks one of them to break. And is it easy to break a bundle of sticks? Is it easy? Is it easy to break a bundle of sticks together when they're tied together?
No.
You can break a single stick, but you can't break a bundle. So the moral of the story was that if you are united, you can be like you can be strong. You know, united to you can be together. You can succeed everywhere. And so he said this story. He told them the story. He said the story of the old man. And that he said that union is strength. So if you are divided, you fall. You know that, no? If you are divided, you are single, alone, and you don't cooperate with others, you don't play with others, you have, don't have friendship, then what happens? You will be alone every time. But if you have friendship and you're all together, when you're united, then you have a strength together. You would have read many stories about friendship and unity, isn't it? Yes or no? Boy, girls?
Yes.
So he said impressive things about friendship, and he told the story of union was strength. So a friend in need was a friend indeed. All of you know this, no? That a friend in need is a friend indeed. He then started giving hair-raising accounts of what hell had in store for persons who fostered enmity. That is, he started giving hair-raising accounts. That is, he told such incidents from the Vedas. Vedas are the holy books of the Hindus. And he says that from the Hindus, like Vedas, come to know that when a person dies, what type of punishment he gets. So he says that he started giving hair-raising accounts, that is, scary accounts. Do you understand what I'm saying, children? He then started giving hair-raising accounts. Do you understand? Girls, are you sleeping better?
Yes,
ma'am. I feel from your voice that you're all sleeping. And of what hell had in store. So, you know that when a person does something wrong, he's sent to hell. We heard the story. And if he does good, he goes to heaven. So what hell had in store for persons who fostered enmity, that is, who encouraged hatred. Fostered enmity means fostered hatred, encouraged hatred. So according to Rajam, it was written in the Vedas that the person who fostered enmity should be locked up in a small room. So he's saying, according to the Hindu Vedas, the story, the books of Veda of the Hindus, it is said that after the death, if the man does something wrong, he's sent to a small room. Okay. Then he's made to stand stark naked on a pedestal. That is, once he's sent into the room, there's a small pedestal. Pedestal is like a tall table. Like, you know, you have seen a statue on a pedestal, right? You must have seen some statues. Haven't you all seen statues? If you don't answer me, how will you? So it is kept on, not a small thing, but it is kept at a height, you know. And what is it kept on? It's kept on a pedestal, okay? And the pedestal, now what does he say that? He'll be kept on the pedestal stark naked, that is, without his clothes. And on the pedestal will be red hot iron. So this is the punishment, you know. And there were beehives all around, with bees as big as lemons. That is, what was the punishment? That after that, he'll be sent to a small room. He'll be made to stand on a pedestal with red hot iron. Then there will be bees of the size of lemon. You know, bees bite you. No, you know that, no? We shouldn't go near the beehive. Because if anybody disturbs the beehive, the bees, you know, they bite. So, if the sinner stepped down from the pedestal, and what is the, you know, the sinner had to face so many difficulties and so many challenges. Like, so if he looked down, what will happen if he stepped down from the pedestal? He have to put his foot on immense scorpions. You all have heard of scorpions? They are very dangerous. Yes. And if they bite, then spread poison. And centipedes are also like, you know, you have seen centipedes, the picture of centipedes? No. They are like caterpillars, but with their thorny body, you know. And if they bite also, poison spreads in your body. So this is Rajam is just telling, making up the stories. Actually, his Veda doesn't have all this, but he's making up stories to convince them that we shouldn't be enemies to anybody, we shouldn't hate anybody. And this type of punishment will be given if a person is wrong, or he is committed some mistake, or he hates somebody. Okay, so imagine if you know that a person has done wrong, he'll be sent to a small room, then he'll maybe stand on a pedestal where the hot iron is there. So it's so difficult to stand on a hot iron. And if he steps down to, you know, avoid standing on the hot iron, what will he do? On the floor, he'll be among the scorpions and the centipedes. So imagine they're biting them. So these are some of the stories that he told. Then a shudder went through the company. That is, company means they had the company of all the six people over there, right? Seven of them. So a shudder. Shudder means, you know, if you hear such stories, you get scared, you know. You're shivering. You get shivering inside suddenly. So the sinner would have to stand for a month without food or sleep. So actually he's exaggerating. He's telling the story just to scare them so that they will become friends again. So the sinner would have to stand there for a month without food or sleep. And at the end of the month, he would be transferred to another place. So he's saying that after 1 month, what will be the sinner will be asked to go to another place. And where is the place? It will be a narrow bridge over a lake of boiling oil, imagine. So you would have seen in some old movies, you know, that time they would say that the villain would get punishment like that. So there will be a narrow bridge where you can hardly walk over there, and below down is the boiling oil, you know. So if he falls, you know, he'll fall in the hot boiling oil. So the bridge was so narrow that he would be able to keep only 1 foot on it at a time. Imagine a narrow bridge, he's balancing himself on the bridge with only 1 foot, you know. And he can, if he wants to move forward also, he has to be very careful and lift the other leg and then put it in front of the first the feet and then move on. So it was difficult, you know. So you can imagine that this type of punishment was given, you know. So even on the narrow bridge, there'll be plenty of wasp nests and cactus. Now again, there'll be lots of wasp nests, that is lots of insects, and cactus. Cactus is plants with thorns, you know. So he would be goaded from behind. So he'll be pushed from behind to move forward. And you can imagine how dangerous the situation would be. So he would have to balance on 1 foot and then on another for ages and ages to keep himself from falling into the steaming lake below and move on indefinitely. So girls, did you understand the punishment that the sinner would get? Girls, I'm asking you a question. Yes, I hope I've explained myself properly, I suppose. And I think now little is left. I'll continue in the next class. Okay, girls?
Okay, ma'am.
And keep reading these. Yes, beta. Keep reading these lessons, because for your MCQs will be given from anywhere from the book. I mean, lesson, okay? Do you understand, beta, what I'm trying to say? Girls, yes, I want an answer from y'all.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So please read the lesson as much as possible. Try to understand everything and be prepared for MCQs also.